So while I am a very ambitious person who managed to build a 32 core monster in a compact case, the thermal solution I used was not the most ideal choice to manage the power of a Threadripper 3970X. But today we have a cooler from Be Quiet, which is designed to handle the 280 watts of TDP that the 3970X is designed with. And we are also going to rebuild my Threadripper PC, and we'll also discuss what kind of RAM you should use with this cooler. Hey guys, I am Siddharth, and this is Be Quiet Dark Rock Pro TR4 review. In the box, you get some manuals, the mounting brackets for the cooler and the fans, including some thermal paste. They have included a very high quality magnetic Phillips screwdriver, which you can also use after you are done installing the cooler. You get two very high quality Be Quiet Silent Wings fans with this. So you have a 135mm fan that will go in the center of the tower, along with a 120mm fan for the front. Then lastly, you get the massive cooler that weighs more than a kilogram. So the version of the cooler that I have only supports TR4 socket, which is identical to the new STRX 4 socket. And it will also work with the EPYC CPUs, but they also have a consumer platform version of the same cooler, which is identical to it, except for the size of the base plate, which supports CPU sockets like AM4, LGA 1151, and even the LGA 2011. Now, while I have used liquid coolers in all of my previous builds, the problem with using them on Threadripper is that most of the liquid coolers don't have a CPU block that covers the big Threadripper IHS completely. So just having a mounting bracket that can support the TR4 socket doesn't mean that you will be able to get great performance out of them. There are some brands who make liquid coolers designed for Threadripper, but there are also some issues with them. But looking at the coolers like the Dark Rock Pro, you can see that it has a big base plate that covers the Threadripper IHS properly, and to add to that, it has 7 heat pipes that will make it more effective at cooling CPUs that generate a lot of heat. We have a twin tower design in this cooler, and the black coated fins also have this interesting shape where you mount the fan for more air pressure and efficiency. You also have this aluminum cover with a brushed finish, which looks pretty great and also adds to the premium feel of this cooler. The case we are going to use is the ASUS TUF GT501, because it's the only one I have that can support a cooler with a height of 162.8mm. So make sure that you check that the case you have will be able to contain this cooler. We'll install this on the ASUS TRX 40E Strix Gaming motherboard, and we'll install the SATA SSD now because it's easier when the motherboard is out. Choosing the right sized RAM is going to be important, so I initially wanted to use the Corsair RGB RAM because I like its simple design, but we are soon going to see some interesting development here. We planned on installing the cooler with the motherboard outside of the case, but we won't be able to tighten one of the screws on the motherboard if we install it now. So we'll install the cooler after installing the motherboard in the case. We are rebuilding this PC with a Corsair RM850X, and we are also going to install some Corsair LL120 fans around the cooler for RGB along with the Corsair light strips. The installation is pretty simple, as all you have to do is mount the installation bracket on the STRX 4 socket, then apply thermal paste which is included in the box, then insert the bridge on its base, and then finally use the screwdriver provided in the box to screw it on the bracket that you installed on the socket through the top aluminum cover. Then you have to install the central 135mm fan, and lastly you have to install the 120mm fan. Now here we ran into a problem with our Corsair RAM, as the fan interfered with its 51mm of height. So we had to switch to my G-Skill Trident Z Royal set, which is short enough to fit here at 43mm even with its RGB lights. We also compared it with ADATA XPG RAM sticks, and I am not sure if they will fit here at 46mm. So just be careful about what model of RAM you choose to ensure that it's shorter than 44mm. Make sure that you are subscribed to the channel with bell icon so you don't miss out on future videos. Then to finish it up, we'll install the ROG Strix 2080 Ti with the tweaked PC custom cables. I was really lucky with this, as the SSD bracket on the motherboard didn't interfere with the fan on this cooler with a gap of less than 1mm. But in a similar situation, you can also mount the fan at rear, and you also get additional mounting brackets So you can also add an extra 120mm fan in any position you like. Coming to the aesthetics, this is a no-nonsense cooler and the name Dark Rock Pro really describes it well. It obviously doesn't have any RGB, but that is very intentional, and in fact, if you are using RGB RAM like me, they will also get blocked with the enormous size that this cooler has. But I really like how it looks. It's difficult to capture on camera because it is completely black, but as far as air coolers go, this looks very stealthy and professional. And you can add an RGB fan if you want. You can also see how you can use the extra bracket provided to mount a non-Be Quiet fan on this, as that will need a longer bracket. So let's finally see how well it performs. And with Prime 95 small FFT test, you can see that it was able to handle the 3970X at 81 degrees Celsius without setting the fans to highest speed, while the 240mm liquid cooler that I used with it initially struggled to dissipate its heat, making it reach 90 degrees Celsius with fans at 100%. Both of these tests were in very different cases with very different levels of airflow, and the front panel was open with the smaller case, so this is just to give you a rough idea of the performance. Coming to the acoustic performance, the brand's name is Be Quiet, so I was expecting that it won't be loud even when it has to work hard, but in spite of my high expectations, I was a little surprised by how silent it is even at full load. At idle, you will not even hear that the PC is running, but even on full load, it is only slightly audible. So even though in the spec sheet, it says that it is designed to handle a 250W TDP, it was able to handle 3970X, which consumes more than 280W of power, which is really great. So overall, the Be Quiet Dark Rock Pro works perfectly in every area. It performs extremely well and can handle a 3970X. It is also extremely silent even on full load. It comes with some of the best performing fans out there, and the box includes all kinds of accessories that you will need. And it also looks pretty great even without any RGB lights. At price of around $90 or 7000 Indian rupees, I really can't think of any way that they could have made this better. And it's also great to see that they are not charging extra over their consumer platform cooler, and if you are able to afford a Threadripper, the cost of this cooler won't even be an amount that you will have to think about. So that was it for this video. I'll have links to buy this cooler in the video description along with other components I showed. Let me know what you think about air cooling in the comment section, and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Subscribe with bell. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.